Hey, SciShow viewers, it's John Green. So over on Crash Course, we just launched a limited series podcast called The Universe, where the astrophysicist Dr. Katie Mack walks me through the history of the entire universe, including the parts that haven't been written yet. Take a look.
It seems like a lot of this stuff was inevitable, that each thing proceeded from the previous thing, right?
Yeah. I mean, you know, there was a sort of series of events where, I mean, it's all just kind of following the same laws of physics once you set it going.
Yeah, that's starting to make me feel a little bit like once you set it going, there was always going to be a galaxy called the Milky Way, not called the Milky Way, but where the Milky Way is, the size and shape of the Milky Way. And it's starting to make me think that there was always going to be a sun, and it's starting to make me think there was always going to be an Earth once we set this stuff in motion. And just to be clear, we didn't set it in motion. And that's starting to make me think, and I'm really hoping you can correct me on this one, that there was always going to be a me.
I mean, the thing is, right, like when you're looking at it from the perspective of now, all you can do is trace back all of the events along the timeline that we have followed. But there were a lot of different places in the past where things could have branched one way or another. It's true that once you set down the primordial fluctuations in the plasma of the hot Big Bang, those kind of have to grow into galaxies and clusters of galaxies, and galaxies have to make stars and planets. But, you know, whether or not they had to make the Earth and us, like there are a lot of things that are just random chaos that come into that. I mean, things like, you know, in the formation of planets, you have collisions between large rocky bodies and asteroids and things and stuff coalescing from the protoplanetary disk. And that could have gone lots of different ways.
So what you're saying is, and I guess what I'm asking is free will still in the equation?
That I feel like that's above my pay grade somehow. I feel like free will is a very human question, and in the work that I do, humans are so insignificant.
Yeah. No, I'm getting that feeling. That's a little bit of a stinger for me, I have to confess, because
yeah,
I know that we don't matter much, but don't we matter a little bit? Here's my argument for why we might matter a little bit. We're the ones doing this observing, and that's interesting.
You know that famous image of the Earth as the pale blue dot? It was Voyager 1. They took a picture of the Earth from billions of kilometers away, and it just looks like a speck of dust. Carl Sagan gave this beautiful speech about how, you know, on that speck of dust, you know, every nation and every powerful ruler and every, you know, king and peasant and, you know, we're all on that little speck of dust. None of us matter. You know, I mean, we're a tiny, tiny speck of dust in the universe. I think about that picture sometimes. And then I think about, well, in the bigger picture, most of the matter in the universe is dark matter that we can't interact with except through gravity, like 85% or something. And most of the rest of the universe, if you just kind of add up the energy of the stuff in the universe, is dark energy. And so if you add up the sort of contribution of both dark matter and dark energy in the universe, in terms of the energy density of the stuff in the universe, that makes up something like 95% of the stuff in the universe is either dark matter or dark energy.
Oh, no.
And so the stuff that we're made of, regular matter, what we call baryons in astrophysics, that regular matter and, you know, electrons and protons and neutrons and you know, even radiation, all of that together makes up about 5% of what the universe is made of. You know, even our kind of matter is kind of an afterthought in the universe in some ways. And so, like, the idea that we as humanity can be significant to the universe when even the stuff we're made of is kind of not very significant in the universe, it's very humbling. It really is very humbling. It's also sort of inspiring because as you said, we can learn so much, right? And we have this amazing power of knowledge of, you know, maybe we're just observers in this bigger cosmos and maybe we're just along for the ride, but we know so much about it.
I tend to think of myself as being an observer of the universe, but we're not actually observers of the universe because we're the universe. Like, we're made out of the universe. So we're the universe observing itself.
Right. Yeah.
And I find that kind of like lovely and encouraging too, that I'm not separate from this thing that I'm looking at. I'm part of it.
So there's this famous quote by Carl Sagan, right? We are a way for the universe to know itself.
Mm. Mm-hmm.
There's a lot more where that came from. The universe is available now, both on the Crash Course YouTube channel and wherever you get your podcasts.